Hey everybody, Phil Tenaglia here again for Matrix Goes to School, and it's that time of year again. You know, the one where we in the Western world are encouraged to celebrate the joys of the season. And while we are getting that message, we are also noticing that all the important stuff we have been doing all along still needs to be done. So the whole celebrating and getting into the spirit thing can be a real blast, or it can get to feel pretty heavy at times, which can lead to less celebrating and more struggling with unwanted stuff. Now, the same thing, if we are in schools, is going on for our students, who will also be noticing the same stuff, and they can get bogged down as well. Now, if we get bogged down, we can use what I call the holiday matrix to get some psychological flexibility going to help us navigate and keep moving toward what's important. Now, it's a bit modified from the traditional matrix, and I chose the tree motif since it seems to speak to the tradition most of us are aware of, so feel free to adjust it to your tradition of choice. So, here's how it works. Under the tree is the mind where the presents show up, kind of like how Santa does it. You don't know quite what you're going to get, but something is usually there. Like most gifts we receive, we get stuff we want, which is the stuff that shows up on the toward side, and stuff we don't want, which usually shows up on the away side. Now, the presents can come in big packages, shiny packages, wrapping paper, all kinds of shapes and sizes. We can notice them all. Since the holidays haven't happened yet, as of this post, it is all showing up right here in our minds. Now, the gifts most of us want will probably come down to who or what is important to us. So we're going to write that down there. And when we ask that question, if we are actually in the five sense experience of being in school, that's pretty much going to come down to our students are important to us. Now, why are we here in this place we call school? What's our shared purpose? Well, we are here, basically most of us, we're here to teach. And the other thing that we're due, the big picture here, is to help kids learn how to learn. That's the big picture. That's what we're up to most of the time. Now, we can also add in our family is important to us and our friends. And we can build this list from there. Now, if we're moving toward learning and collaborating, which is the other thing we're going to be doing with our students, we're going to be collaborating with them in this business called education, we can move toward any number of other things, and other gifts are liable to show up under the tree, especially during the holidays. Stuff like excitement and celebrating might show up, and joy, and I like to throw in world peace, since that's my personal favorite that I try to move toward, and it can be lots of fun most of the time. Now, since our minds are always churning out presents for us, what also shows up under the tree are the gifts that we are less enthusiastic about. So here I want you to think about that handmade sweater that you get from your great aunt every year. And the other stuff that can show up is the stuff like stress will show up. And we have these things called deadlines in schools most of the time. We do this other thing that shows up. We have these things called meetings that show up. And other thoughts that might be showing up inside of us. I don't have time. Too much to do, right? Too much to do will definitely show up. Another thing we're thinking about a lot is this thing called shopping. Put that kind of in the middle because shopping can be either be a toward or an away, depending on how you feel about it. And the other thing that might show up is this thing that shows up inside of me, which is no cash, right? How am I going to pay for all this stuff, right? So these are the gifts we like to return or exchange, but we don't have a choice. They are showing up and they are ours. Not wanting them doesn't make them go away. So while all of this is showing up in us, and let's not forget, it's also showing up inside of our students, we go up here into the world of behaviors, and we decorate our tree with either toward or away moves. Now, we can be decorating to try to avoid the unwanted gifts, or we can be decorating to move toward who or what's important to us. We can choose to open our gifts up, play with them, or just take them with us depending on the situation we are in. So, for example, we can go up here and we can do the thing that a lot of us like to do, myself included. We can come up here and we can complain about all this stuff. Or we can basically not do it. That can be something we certainly can do. I'm just not going to do it. Or we can argue with each other about who's going to do it and how it's going to get done. And generally, we can just kind of avoid this stuff, right? Now, like broken lights on the tree, sometimes these moves here might work, but a lot of the time they don't, and they just work to kind of increase the stuff that shows up down here, the discomfort that we're feeling. So, we can also come over here, and we can notice if we're decorating our tree by doing some toward moves. So, some toward moves might be, well, what the heck, we can just keep right on teaching. And we can be working to be engaging our students in that whole learning enterprise. We can be helping out where we need to. And we can also get some celebrating in. And we can also get some visiting in. So these are some of the tour moves. Now, the extra bonus is modeling for our students when we do these things how to keep moving toward the who's and what's that are important, even when things may not be going our way. And while we're doing all of these things, we could be noticing that all of this stuff is showing up inside of us, and we can also be noticing how well what we're doing up here is working to get us where we want to go, while we're also noticing the stuff that's showing up inside of us. So, a fun thing to do as the holiday approaches is to use the matrix to notice the presents that show up under our tree and what we do with them. In the process of educating and helping, we will be making both toward moves and away moves. And we can notice our moves and what happens when we do them. So this is the way to use the psychological flexibility model to survive the holidays and hopefully keep fun and creativity going at the same time. Thanks a lot.